Hi, I'm Nicholas Lodge and would like to introduce you to my new peony and tulip mould and veiner. And this is, again, a very innovative part of our new flower pro line. So first of all, on this mat, there are four cavities. One, two, three, four, for a small, a medium, large, and extra large petal. And we use these for the Oriental peony, which I'm going to show you in this segment, the classic peony, which is more like the cabbage style peony, and also for tulips, either quick tulips or obviously things like parrot tulips, which are going to be shown in separate YouTube tutorials. On here, there is also the stamens for when you make tulips. One, two, three. For those of you who have already watched my, for example, lily YouTube, so this is made in the same sort of way as the lily stamens. And then this is the stigma, which is the top of the tulip. So when we make the tulip centers, we will use this part. And here is actually the part I'm going to use in a moment, which is going to be to make the center of the Oriental style lily. This has a mat, which is the back petal veiner. So just like when I do my flowers, like for example, poinsettias, this will be lined up with the wire as you're going to see in a short while. So let's get started. So first of all, with Oriental peonies, Oriental peony is basically a winter flower, and it's a peony that grows in Asia, in China, in Japan, and things obviously where it's native, usually in the winter time. And it's a more of a flat peony, and it has like exposed stamens in the middle. And then you have the classic peony, which is a popular one obviously for weddings and things, which is more of like a cabbage style, where you think of a cabbage or a Brussels sprout, it's almost built onto a ball shape, okay? But when we make the Oriental peony, we have the center part. Now this can be made, this part, in yellow, pale yellow, dark yellow. You can also make it in pale green as well. And so depending on what variety of peony or what color you're going to make, you can change the color of this. So we're going to start off with here a 20 gauge wire, and I'm going to use some half width floral tape. So just like in my other segments, this is cut with my tape cutter where it would divide the tape into two, or you would obviously use a pair of scissors. I'm using here light green, but you can also do this in, for example, more of a sort of a dark pink. You could do it in obviously red. So you could use a moss green or a sort of an olive green floral tape as well. So we're going to take the floral tape. We're just going to just stretch that a little bit. And we're going to make a floral tape bud 5 × hook × 8. So just going to start around the end of the wire, and then we're going to go around once, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We're then going to take my pliers here, and I'm going to just fold that over, squash that down, so we're making a hook on the end of the wire like this. And then we're going to go 8 times on top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'm just going to come down the stem a little bit, okay? So we're going to come down this wire just a little tiny bit, because we're going to add some extra wires in a moment. Now we're then going to measure off your paste. So we're going to measure off a number 7 size ball of paste. I'm using here just a Renshaw yellow straight out of the pack. Of course, you could add white to this, but also you could make pale green, or obviously color white paste yellow. So you can use obviously whatever you have, if you've got pre-colored paste, or as I said, we're going to use number 7 size. So again, 1/3 below, 2/3 above. We need to condition this. So a little bit of vegetable shortening here to condition it. And then once we've conditioned this, we're going to then take the floral tape bud. I'm going to put just a little bit of egg white onto here. So just a little bit of egg white onto your floral tape bud. Just keep that in, remember, a wet towel. We're going to just insert this into the ball of paste. Just going to use a little bit of corn flour, cornstarch on your fingers on the back of this. And then what we're going to do here is going to just make this into a long cone shape. So this long cone shape wants to be basically the length of the cone on the mold, okay? So it just wants to be that length here. So we're using the this really a little different than, like, for example, things like the rose cone molds, where we actually rotate this, because what we're doing here is we're using that as a guide of shape. But what we're actually having here, you can see on the bottom of this mold, there is this little line, okay? So this little line is on the bottom here, like this, okay? And what we're actually going to do here, we're going to divide this piece of paste into 3 sections, okay? So how we do that is you place the mold into here, okay? Using your fingers from the side, you're just gonna just gently sort of almost like press just a little bit like each side. So you're almost creating a rim here. So you see, when you take that out, you're gonna get that line on there, okay? And then what you do is when you remove it, you rotate this so that the line will actually be directly on the side of the mold there, okay? And you see, then you're gonna just do the same thing. So what we're doing is almost just like pinching a little bit of a ridge on there. This will be the second one. And then you rotate it around. So you see, you've got like now the two lines on, and then you rotate this around to the third line, which will be here. And you're just gonna just press this on here, like so. So when you take this out, you're gonna have, this is gonna be divided into three lines onto it, all right? So now we're gonna do this very similar to the way I showed the lily buds. And we're going to use just a little bit smaller scissors here. But when we did the lily bud, we're going to use same technique. So we're gonna use the scissors on their side. These are spring action scissors. And so on the side with the scissors, you're gonna cut in like this, all right? So we're gonna make a little cut, so it looks like a little beak. But you see, because you've only cut into where the line is, that means you haven't gone like, it's not in half, it's almost like one third. And then you rotate this around, and then where the second line is, which is here, you're just gonna take your scissors here, and you're just gonna just cut down the middle, you see? So when we open this up, we're actually going to, this will just curl back like this, and this just curls back, one, two, three, like so, you see? So it makes, it looks a little bit like a pomegranate, all right? So it's like a lily bud, but so that's obviously how we would make the first stage, okay? So you've got the three lines on there, and then of course you've actually got it marked into three sections, like so, okay? And that just curls back. Now, you want to let that dry for about 2 hours. After you've let that dry for about 2 hours, this one is dry, we're going to now take some stamens. Now, these are seed head stamens, okay? So these are actually, as I said, called seed head stamens, large seed head stamens, and use these for daffodils and flowers like that. What you're actually going to do here is you're going to take approximately about a third of a bunch. So it actually means out of one bunch of stamens, you'll have enough for about three peonies, okay? And so, of course, you could make these time. I'm going to take your tweezers. So with my tweezers here, I'm just going to divide this one third of a bunch into three smaller bunches, okay? So they just approximate, you don't have to count these. And then what we're going to do here is you're going to just tap these level. Okay, so you're going to tap them level here, like so. And you will just cut them with your pair of scissors in the middle here. So generally the best way to do that is hold each side, just going to cut these. So you see how you're going to make like a little bundle here. All right, and you just will continue making the little bundles. So you'll actually have six smaller bundles. I usually found this is the easiest way to do this. So you just see how I hold this with my fingers. Just cut those in half. And then the last little bunch here. So I said, this is one third of a bunch of stamens. And then we've divided this into, as I said, into one third. And then each third is cut into. So we have six little bundles. Now we're going to use dental floss. So dental floss I used also on my lily. Okay, so take off a decent amount. But this is waxed, all right? So you need to make sure you do use waxed dental floss, because waxed dental floss will almost like stick to itself. Some of the dental floss is also, the unwaxed one typically doesn't sort of stick to itself. But you're just going to just take this. So I'm going to take the little loop on here like I did on my, just going to go up the wire here, so it's almost making like a little knot on there, like this. Just going to trim off the excess dental floss, okay? And then we're going to take your little stamens in groups. So you're just going to just take these in little groups. So this is the little bunch here. I'm just going to just take these, just sort of place them. So the bottom of the stamen is going to be here like this. So you're just going to have just a little bit of obviously the thread part of the stamen, and you're going to go around a couple of times each time, you see? So this is going to secure this onto the wire, okay? And then you're going to take your next group. Just, I found this is easier to do it in small groups. And then your next groups are going to go around here. So this is going to come all the way around the bottom of the, do you see how this is going to create this crown of stamens? Now again, if you don't have dental floss, you can use floral tape, but what you would need to do is, like on my Flower Pro, when I did the baby's breath, you'll need to cut your floral tape to about 1/6 of a width. So you take half-width floral tape, so you would take actually this, and then with a pair of scissors, you'd cut this into thirds. because the thing is if you don't want to add too much bulk here to this bottom here, you see this is going to go around to create your crown of stamens, okay? But there's no sort of set number, you're just going to, but I found it said usually about one third of a bunch of a standard bunch of stamens is usually sufficient. Just going to go around, and if you have a few little straggly ones here, you can just pop those in. And then once you get the stamens in here, right, so these are the last little ones there, just going to go around with your, and then just with your dental floss, you're going to just come down here. So this is just going to secure the stamens. And you can actually use your dental floss. You see how it just actually winds down? Now, dental floss is quite strong. It's almost a bit like a thread. So you'll need to just use a pair of scissors to cut that. And all right, so at this point here, so now we're going to add two more 20-gauge wires. So you add these 20-gauge wires right at the bottom here of the, so right where the dental floss is there. And then you're going to just take your, now your half-width tape, you're just going to tape to just really where the base of where the stamens are. And you're just going to tape down here and just going to continue taping down to the bottom here, okay? And then once you tape down to the bottom, so now what we can do is you can open these up. And you see how this is going to give you this sort of beautiful crown of stamens. So we can use a similar technique. Obviously the center is different, but we can use a similar technique for a poppy where you're putting black stamens around the center. You can also use this for like anemones and flowers like that, where you have like a green center or yellow center and black stamens around the outside. So this is ready for coloring. So of course at the end of this particular YouTube, I'm going to show you all the coloring. So we're going to be dusting a nice sort of soft green on here and some pink to match in with our petals. So next step is going to be to move on to the actual petals of the peony. So I'm going to be using the mats here and showing the petals. I'm going to show you the coloring and assembly of the peony. So now we're going to move on to the actual petals of the Oriental style peony. So I'm going to be using a pale pink. This is actually the same formula that I showed in my first book one for the pink roses. This is actually a Renshaw pink flower modeling paste or gum paste, 85 grams of that with 15 grams of white sugar paste or rolled fondant. Because the peony, we need a slightly softer paste because we've got to frill the petals. Remember also that you can add a little bit of egg white to this if you want to give the paste more elasticity. So typically for orchids, peonies, roses, like shown on my introduction to the paste. Remember there's a separate YouTube which actually deals with about the paste, adding egg white to it to make the sort of more elastic. Anyway, so when we make the peony, I'm going to start off with the little smallest size petals. So we have four petals on here, small, medium, large, and extra large. Okay, now each of them is going to use a different size piece of paste because obviously they're different sizes, plus also there'll be three wires used throughout. So we're going to start off here with your paste here. So it's going to be a number seven small, okay, so it's going to be a number seven that just goes through the hole. Now of course with the peonies, all right, we're going to make five of these first stage petals, okay, so there'll be five of these. So we're going to just condition this paste, so we're just going to condition it, and then we're going to just make this into a little cone shape, almost like a little rose cone here. And this wants to be approximately about sort of two-thirds of the height of the petal. So whatever petal you're doing, it wants to be about two-thirds of the height. And then what I actually do there, you can just use a little one flower. You're just going to use the back of the flat side of the peony and just press that. And then you're going to place this in. Now another way you can do that is you can actually just put a little cornstarch on your paste. You can actually put it into the mold, and then once it's in the mold, you can just press it in there with the back. So what this is going to do is going to, because the peony is a wider petal, this is going to just sort of get it started in the mold, okay? All right, and then we're going to finish this off with your cosmetic sponge in my classic way of using the Flower Pro. You see how you're just working the paste here to the edge. So this will mean the edge of your petals are nice and fine, and obviously it's a little bit thicker in the middle, okay? And then what I'm going to do here is I'm going to actually put, using my fingers, I'm just going to create like a little bit of a, almost like a little ridge here for the wire to go into. So I'm just going to create a little slight thickness there. This is a 28 gauge wire, okay? So with a 28 gauge wire, white wire, and I'm using white wire because obviously if we use green wire, it would look ugly. And you're going to put on when you're working with white or pastel colors. Now, if this was a red peony, you of course could get away with green wire. You're going to put it into the little channel, all right? It's a little channel that's already in there. You're just going to put that into the channel and just going to thread this into the about a third of the way into the petal, okay? I'm just going to make sure you just press this. This only needs to go in about a third of the way in. Then you're going to take the back of the map here. Just line this up. So you see this is lined up, so the V shape of here is directly where the petal is. I'm just going to just press this onto here. All right, so you can see how that's going to, it's going to just take this out of the mold here like that. Now, as you can see, this is the back of the petal, all right? This is the sort of the back of the petal. So one side is heavier. You can see this is obviously will be the inside of it, all right? So basically what we're going to do here is on this side, which will be the back, all right? We're going to use the Dresden tool on its side, and we're going to feather the edge of this. All right, so we're just going to go around the petal here, just around the top half of this with the Dresden tool. So this is going to be done on the, when you take it out of the mold, don't turn it over, okay? And I'm going to show you this twice. So you're going to do this on the back. Then you're going to turn your pad over, and then you're going to turn your petal over, okay? So now we're on the sort of heavier side. So we're going to just use your Dresden tool and just going to work from the outside to the inside. So you see this will be the heavier side up, okay? And then we're going to just hollow the base of the petal. So you just bring this off of the pad with the veining tool, just going to hollow the base. Now, the smaller petals are going to dry in a crepe foam former, all right? So this is just a crepe foam former like that. So they'll just dry like this, okay? Now, medium petals, all right? Medium petals will be number 8 small. Again, 5 of those. The only difference is we're using 26 gauge wire. It's a little bit of a stronger wire, okay? And this can be used also for, you know, tulip petal as well, a medium-sized tulip. Which we'll be talking about in the tulip YouTube. And then we're going to move on to then the large size petal, okay? So the large size petal, that's going to be a number 9 small. So basically you have 7 small, 8 small, 9 small, 28 gauge wire here, 26 here, 26 here, okay? And then I'm going to show you just the larger one because we dry that a little differently. And so all 3 of the small, medium, and large can be dried in your crepe foam former. Now they don't take long to dry, so obviously you're going to need a couple of these, but you can just lay these in, and then what I would do is probably 15, 20 minutes, you'll be able to take these out, and then generally just sort of hang them on your hanging rack like this, so they will just continue drying, okay? And again, if you have a food dehydrator, that's going to speed up the whole drying process. Now when we do the large size, or extra large size, which is this one here. This is also the same one I'm going to use for the parrot tulip, which I'll be showing in my, obviously is on my parrot tulip YouTube. So this one is done in exactly the same way. So we're going to take it's a little bit easier to see, obviously it's on a larger scale. So again, we're just going to just make this into a cone shape. So it wants to be approximately about 2/3 or carrot shape, about 2/3 of the length of this. Okay, just gonna just dust this with some little bit of corn starch. Now remember, you can either press this in like this to flatten it down, or you can actually put this at this stage into the mold here, and then just position it, and then you can just actually press this in with the silicone press, the back of this. All right, so what this is gonna do, this is just gonna sort of get this established into the mold, you see? And then we're just going to work this to the back here. So just going to work this out to the edge of the mold using your cosmetic sponge. I'm just going to work this out. And then we're just going to create like almost a ridge down the center as well. So remember, this is number 11. So this is number 11 regular size. So this is the number 11 regular size, which would be just sitting 1/3 below, 2/3 above. All right, and you're gonna just sort of create that. If you're having sort of issues doing that, you can also just use you can just sort of like roll from the outside to the inside. So you see how you can actually create like almost like a little ridge in here, all right, with your small companion tool, okay? But that wants to be directly here. Now this one is going to be 24 gauge wire, okay? The 24 gauge wire, we're going to take this And I'm going to just again, I'm going to take this and just going to thread this into the that one third of the way in. Okay, you should just feel this tickle your finger as it goes into the mold. And then you will take this, just going to press this into over the surface area like that. Okay, and then we're just going to just take this out. Just release this just gently from the mold. Okay, so it's going to give you a petal. So though we're using mold, you can, these petals are nice and thin. This would be the same thickness if you were using like a groove board. So we're going to put this, so remember, this is how it came out. So remember, this is going to be like the back of the petal. See, this is the heavier side, which will be on the front, okay? So we're going to take this, so we're going to place it onto here. So we're going to do on work on the green side first. And we're going to do this on the top half of the petal. So you see how I'm just going to work this with my Dresden tool. So this will basically be back on the back of your petal. Okay, so it's going to be on your back, and then you're going to turn over your pad, and you're going to turn over. So this will be actually on the front. And you see, then we're going to just blend from the outside to the inside here. And see how you're going to get blend to get these really lovely frills onto there. And then you're going to just hollow the base. So you can use, like obviously on your smaller ones, you can use your veining tool. On the bigger one, you can use your Dresden tool on its side, like this. Now these are going to be dried in an egg former. So this is just a chocolate candy mold, okay? So this is just an egg shape, all right? So this is actually like a 2.5-inch size egg, okay? So it's about approximately about 6.5 centimeters in length. So what you would do is you take your petal and you just would dry this into, just sort of let it rest in there. You're not pushing it in, but you just let it rest into the egg former, okay? So that is one option. The second option is you just use a spoon. So this is just a tablespoon, which is about the same size, all right? So you're just going to see obviously what size you want to get a tablespoon about that size. And then what you would do there is you just would form this over a piece of aluminum foil. So you just would make your cavities here. And obviously you need to use a couple of pieces of foil. These are food service sheet foils used to wrap, you know, like hot dogs and different sort of foods, potatoes, things like that. So it's a softer foil than like a roll of aluminum foil, which typically is a little bit too stiff. And then you see here, you just would dry this into the former in the same way. So this would just sit into the former, so it just sort of rests into the former like that, okay? And that's how you would dry your petals. So you have the choice of using that, but you can find as I said, you know, different formers, but as I said, a spoon works really well. You just want to find something that, as you can see here, the spoon is about, this is actually about sort of 6.5-7 centimeters long, okay? So just sort of find something in your kitchen that is a suitable size, a plastic or metal spoon. So with this production, you'd make 5 of the small petals, 5 of the medium petals, 5 of the large petals, okay? And then you're going to make 5 or 10 or 15 of the extra large, because this flower obviously always starts off the same in the middle, and obviously as it grows, so the bigger the flower you want, the basically the more of the extra large size petals, okay? So I'm going to actually use 10 of the extra large. So I'm going to use 5, 5, 5. And then 10. So we will have 25 petals on this one flower. And so in the next step, I'm going to show you how to color this and then how we assemble it. So now we're going to move on to, first of all, the taping. So these petals are now dry. So using some half width light green or green of your choice floral tape, I'm going to start about 2 centimeters down, about 1/2 inch, and I'm just going to slide this up. So using this technique here, sliding it up like a little tube, what this does is it enables you to have a nice start. And you want to tape down about 2.5 centimeters, about 1 inch down the stems. Remember, just keep a little tension on your tape. Now once we've got this completed, we're going to then move on to the coloring. Okay, so I'm going to use a napkin here. I'm going to use a color here called Cosmos. This is a nice sort of pink. This is actually a color I used in book one for the cherry blossom. Okay, so I use this on sweet peas, and it's a very nice color contrast. You can see here when you have this color onto the pale pink. All right, so very, very pretty color. So I'm going to use this color now on all 25 or 30 or 35 petals, because it depends on how many big one extra large you want to do. You're going to just use the pink, and we're just going to go around the edge. So we're just going to go around the edge. So we're using a flat brush, just working from the outside to the inside with your pink like this. So generally what I do when I dust personally, I like to just sort of do like a production line. So you see how you have this pale pink just around the edge, and you just would go along doing this on all of your petals, okay? So you're just going to do this on all of your petals. You're going to get this sort of soft pink on the edge. Now of course, if you were doing, if you wanted your peony to be very, very subtle, you could just do this and then pretty much a little bit of soft green and just leave it like this. I'm going to go in with a little bit more sort of dramatic stripes on here. But it's going to be also dependent on what the client wants, okay? There are some varieties of peonies that you just would do like little splotches here and there of red or pink as well. Now, once we get to that stage, we're going to take some, you're going to use the same brush, but this side on its side, and we're going to actually cut into the petals. So we're just going to just cut into the petal here like this. So don't load too much color onto the brush. We're going to get this almost like a sort of stripe, okay? You see how you're going to do this on the, just sort of random. You don't do this the same on every one. See how you're going to have this sort of pink stripe here, okay? And we're going to do the same on the, so you just would do this on all of the petals. Now when you do the small ones, you could even swap out to like a smaller flat angled brush, you know, for the little tiny ones. I actually did this, use this same brush throughout, but because then you'll have pretty much the same effect, but you can use a smaller flat brush just to cut in like this, okay? All right, so we're going to just do this both sides, front and back. And then we're going to use a little bit of the pink on the stamens. So I've done some of these. So we're going to just actually put a little bit of the pinky color onto the stamens as well. So you're just going to have this just sort of, so you get this nice sort of soft yellowy pink color. But that would also be reflective of the color used on the flower. So whatever dust you're using on your petals, you'd use this onto your flower. And if you're doing a white peony, a peony, you generally are going to just leave these stamens yellow. Okay? So that would be the pink. And then we're going to swap out with some green. So I'm going to use the light apple green. So this is a color that I used quite a few, like on the lily centers. I use this a lot. It's a nice sort of springy green color. And we're going to use your smaller flat brush here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do like three stripes. So you're going to come down the middle, and you're going to come up here, and you're going to come up here. So you're going to do like three stripes of this pale green. And you're going to do the same on the back. So you're going to do one stripe a little bit longer. It's going to come down about 2.5 centimeters, and then a little bit to the green to the right and to the left. So you just have this nice sort of subtle green color, this pale green. And again, of course, on a peony that is, has got darker colors, you could of course use a darker green. So 1, 2, and 3, okay. Then I'm going to put a little bit of green onto my, just onto the tip of my yellow. So you're going to have this sort of nice sort of soft green onto there. Okay. And then I'm going to just finish off with a little bit of, this is the prairie green here. I'm just going to put just a little bit of that just around the very, very base of the stamens, just so that you get this slightly darker green. So you do this around the, so just above where the floral tape is. So a little bit of the prairie green here, and then you're just going to go into the very, very bottom here, a little bit of the prairie, because this is just going to be a little bit stronger. You can see a little bit stronger color just at the base here. So it looks a little bit like a pineapple, so like a yellow pineapple with obviously its little green, your green tips on there, okay? And then, so that would be the sort of the coloring. But remember, if you, you know, like obviously on a search engine like Google, you can just Google Oriental peonies. It's going to bring up sort of hundreds of images of obviously flowers that are going to be different colors. So we're going to start off now with the assembly. Okay, so we obviously have your petals here. So we have five extra small. We have, five small. We have five medium. We have five of the, let's see here, so this is this one here. And then we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 of this one's here, okay? And then we've got 10 of the extra large size ones here, okay? So these will be all of my peony petals. So of course, this is quite a time consuming flower. So of course, Flower Pro, the advantage of Flower Pro is because it's going to generally cut flower, make it in half. And because if you're using a classic method of using cutters and then veiners, you know, the whole process, especially if you're using a groove board, which is a traditional way of making wired petals, it sort of, this does speed up things. But this is a really stunning flower, and I'm going to just use this one flower on its own on a cake. When I do the classic peony, in the classic peony segment in the YouTube of the classic peony, I'm going to show how to make a peony bud, which is similar technique to the way I showed the quick peony bud, but using 6 petals and using obviously the mould, not just the blossom cutter. But you have the option, of course, on this one as well, of making a bud and making leaves. And then there's a separate YouTube on using the peony leaf mould, which is a new mould that we have out in the Flower Pro collection. And that, of course, could be used for all 3 peonies. So it's very much mix and match, depending on how you're wanting to use the flowers in a more contemporary, modern style wedding, or whether you're wanting to use it in a more classic way with other flowers. So you're going to take your peony petals here. And then what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to start off, just going to bend the petals slightly with my pliers here. And these are going to be the first 5 petals. Now, when you're doing flower petals like this, all right, we want to, because we want this to be closed up, if you put the petals right here, what's going to happen is sometimes you're on, not so much on a peony, but on some flowers when you assemble them, it means your flower is very open, all right? But so what you want to do is the petals want to actually sort of start here, just sort of down where the sort of bulk of floral tape is. So that means we're going to get them nice and tight, you see? I'm going to use the half-width floral tape. I'm just going to go around. And then the second one will just go slightly overlapping, okay? So second one, third one. So you're just creating this sort of overlap, 3, and then 4 and 5, okay? And then the fourth one will go here. So they're just sitting at the bottom. This is the fourth one, and this is the fifth one, okay? And the fifth one will go on top of the fourth one and then just be tucked inside the first one. So you see how you're creating this sort of lovely sort of cluster, see? All right, so you see how they're really almost like forming a spiral, okay? And you're going to see this obviously several more times, all right? So that's going to be your first layer. Then you're going to then put the petals on. Now, especially when you're using like these, you know, these wires here, generally just again, just going to bend these out just a little bit, because this is obviously on a 26 gauge wire. And especially on the 24 gauge wire, you want to always bend the wire, because if you, of course, just try and bend the petals, sometimes they'll snap, because the petal often is stronger, the wire is stronger than the petal. All right, so then the next one is going to go on. So again, see how, so this first one is going to start, you see that's where a seam is, so you're going to put the first petal onto here, okay? And this again, I'm coming down just a little way, so this will be my next petal, and this will be my second one, then the third one, the fourth one, and the fifth one, okay? So 3. So you see how it's going to form the row here? And this is going to be my fourth one, and then my fifth one. I said I'm going to, this is just certainly a statement flower, okay, when it's finished, okay? And then see, so this one here, again, is just going to sort of just tuck inside that next one. So you see how, and then you can just sort of open the petals out a little bit. You can see how it's starting to open out now. Then we're going to go on to the next petals. All right, so these are going to be, here we've got the larger ones here. So we're going to put those in. And this will be the second one. And then the, so these are going to just go in here like that. You just sort of bend them as you go. So you're just coming down very, very slightly, okay? Now, if you're doing a smaller cake, you know, so if you were doing a, you know, smaller cake, like an 8-inch cake or just an anniversary birthday cake, you could leave it at this stage, okay? So you could just leave it at the, this will be like 15 petals, okay? So it's going to have this. So you see, this is going to make a beautiful, beautiful peony just on its own, okay? So this is using, of course, the, this is 5 small, 5 medium, and 5 large, okay? Now, sometimes, you know, when you're, of course, these petals are quite frilly, and if you've especially made them thin on the edge, you could have a little problem with like a little chip. Don't worry too much about that, and if that does happen, all right, you're not going to notice it. But what I would do is, once you've then finished, just go back in with a little bit of your pink and then just dust over if you did have a little breakage, okay? Because they're obviously frilly, frilly flowers here, okay? Now we're going to move on to the outside petals. So we're going to have 10 of these. So you can just use 5, and you're going to see in each stage how this will look with 5 petals. Or with 10 petals, and of course, if I wanted to, I could go on with another 5 to make 15 of these larger petals. So basically, depending on, you know, how big a cake you're working on, are you using just peonies, are you mixing it with other flowers, you know, basically budget, that's a very important part of flower making, is basically what the client is going to want to spend, or when you do this for, like, as I tell my students, for our family members or friends, how much we love them, okay? You know, because obviously this is all investment of time. But you can see this is obviously beautiful as is. But then we're going to start now adding the outer petals here. So we're going to now start the outer petals here. So we have 1. We have 2. We have 3. They're going to clank around a little bit. And then we have 4, and we have 5. You see? So really stunning flower. So that's just with 5. So that is actually 20 petals. So we have here 5, 5, 5, and 5, okay? And then I'm going to just finish this off with another 5 of the extra large size here. The other little tips, you know, I'll share with you, like, this is a lot of times when students come to my classes, my hands-on classes, or I often get questions, you know, when you tape each of the petals, by taping each of the petals with floral tape, what this means is then when you actually put the flower together, you see these petals, although they're a little bit clanky, but they're going to stay put because we have the floral tape on there, and that's going to hold the petal in place, okay? But you're just going to put these outside petals on. And then we're going to go sort of just in between here. And it's going to, so this is going to go in between. And then if you wanted to, you have the option of course, going to the next level. So just make sure you get these in between. So this is in between, this is in between, yeah, okay. And then the last one will go, it's going to go here. And sometimes you get like, just make sure where you are. There we go. It's going to be that one here. Like that. There we go. All right. And so you see how that's going to give you your flower. Okay. So this has got 25 petals on the flower here. We're going to take this down. Now remember, we used 3. You know, we used 1 wire to make the center, and then we added another wire. Now, when you are doing flowers like this, when they're going into a cake, all right, we're going to use a plastic poly dowel to put this in. But if you were, for example, using this into a spray where you don't really want this bulk here, what you can actually do there is, once you just take down just a little ways, you can actually take your, you know, and you can actually get rid of a lot of these wires. So you can get rid of some of your bulk here just using your wire cutters. So you can just sort of cut through those. And this will obviously just reduce the bulk of the stem. Because I'm putting this into a tube, I don't need to worry about that. But as I said, for certain sometimes flower arrangements, especially for certain flowers, because peony has in real life a fairly thick stem. But you know, certain flowers we sometimes have to, we want to trim down a little bit here. I'm just going to re-tape this. And this is a good example of a little bit like in my poinsettia YouTube, you know, with my Flower Pro poinsettia. When you do flowers that you can't really like access all the petals, you're going to, it's best to put the, do the coloring first and then assemble. But you see how this is going to give you your peony, all right? And then what we're gonna do here is we're gonna just steam this. Now when we steam this, it's just gonna sort of set the color, and obviously as I said, just give, but you see the nice color in here on the peony, all right? And so when we set this, it's just gonna sort of set the colors. This is actually gonna sit a little bit, gonna be showing you some putting on one of our YouTubes we're presenting from this Flower Pro series. We're going to do one on putting flowers onto cakes. We've had some requests from our Facebook group about showing that, so I'll be showing that. And I'm gonna use this on a pale green wedding cake. And so what I'm gonna do here is now I'm going to just obviously rotate that in the steam. There we go. And that will be your Oriental style peony, okay? So I hope you've enjoyed this presentation of obviously the Oriental style peony. Now remember, I'm going to, in my other YouTubes, on the classic peony, which is the cabbage style peony, I will actually be showing you how to make the bud. So obviously if you wanted to add a bud to an Oriental style peony, you just follow the directions for that, exactly the same, same shape, everything, except obviously the color would be the same color as I'm using here or whatever your peony is. And also you could use the leaves. So there's going to be another YouTube, if you check out my YouTube on peony leaves, which is one of my new Flower Pro molds and veiners, that will show you how to make peony leaves. So again, if you wanted to add leaves to this and buds to this, you just follow those two YouTubes, and obviously that would obviously enhance the flower if you wanted it to be. But I'm going to use this as a more contemporary style flower, just on a very simple cake, because obviously with the more contemporary style modern weddings, a lot of brides are using just the flowers, not so much foliage or buds, and as I said, so I hope you've enjoyed this, and I'll see you real soon. So sweet wishes, and until we meet again, bye bye.